2016 Sea Otter Classic. Wow, what an event. 26 years in the making, and here we are, and it's just a crescendo of a bunch of fun and a lot of people in competition. This event had over 350 journalists, international folks coming in and writing about it, and we think 600 or 800 product releases, but 600 amateur competitors and 125 pro team competitors that came in this year. Just phenomenal. And we had little kids and little BMX tracks that were trying out new products. So by far the most successful event. We want them to come back next year. We want more international visitors to come next year. We want to keep growing it. The economic impact's 10% more than last year. Last year was somewhere around $30 million. So we're guessing about $33 million in total economic impact. If you had a multiplier on that, that would mean another $15 to $20 million floating in the economy during the week, Monday through Sunday of the entire event. And that's people coming in, unpacking, setting up their vendor booths, going out and eating, trying some new things, maybe going out on some whale tours, and then coming back and working really hard.
In 1990, I retired from the Marine Corps as Lieutenant Colonel, and a friend and I, who I had met in Rotary, decided to start an event management business together. Where it happened to be in a bike shop, Joslin's Bike Shop, and the bike owner said, well, you guys should put on a mountain bike race. And that was in late 1990, and in April, we hosted the first event out at the Laguna Seca for mountain biking. Is called the Laguna Seca Challenge. And that first year we had 500 athletes and maybe 150 spectators. And that was the start of the Sea Otter Classic. We renamed it a couple years later to Sea Otter. And this past year we had over 70,000 people in attendance and you know, close to 450 exhibitors and visitors from around the world. So it has grown quite a bit in a quarter of a century. Probably our biggest growth and our largest growth, though, has been our expo. When we started a number of years ago, we had maybe one booth, one 10x10 booth out there, and it grew to two, and we didn't really pay a whole lot of attention to how the expo was developing. That wasn't a focus for us. For a number of years now, though, it has become a very big focus, and we've grown to be the largest consumer cycling event in the world. And with 450 exhibitors, that represents probably 900 cycling brands and outdoor lifestyle brands that come and set up out at Laguna Seca every April.
This event's been actually a really big part of Monterey County for so many years that people look forward to it for quite a long time before it comes up, and they get excited and start to prep for it quite a bit ahead. And it just feels like a part of Monterey County. There's so many people here that are very generous and interested in local organizations, and it helps me get my message out to a lot more people, and to people in the industry and local people, and even people from New Hampshire. Like I met yesterday, and it's just it's really nice to feel a part of the whole bike community in general, and feel so well received in that.
Sea Otter's great. So this is 26 year. I did the very first one. It was called the Laguna Seca Challenge. It used to go up around just the hill here, probably like about 7 laps. So you know, ever since then I've been riding them. I probably missed about 5 of them altogether. Volunteered for 3 of them with the youth group. We did the feed zone. That was fun as well, so gave back to the community. It was fun.
Excellent.
Here I am, out here, 57-year-old kid.
Well, what it was like to compete this year was very tough because I wasn't in the best biking shape. It was probably the hardest one I've done simply because I wasn't ready to do it. But the event I did was the cross country, category 3 as they call it. So you have professionals, category 1, category 2, category 3. Even though I've been biking for a long time, you know, probably 45 years, I'm still only in category 3 because it provides the the best avenue for amateurs. So my race was cross country, 15 miles, where the pros for cross country race 32 miles. And it's so great to have it at Fort Ord, because you can have a mountain bike race 32 miles long and you don't have to do circles. It's just one big race course. You don't repeat anything, which is a real prize when you're racing. I started off in the middle and I ended in the middle. So I passed a lot of people, I had a few people pass me, and I ended roughly in the middle of the pack right where I started.
This is one of the largest biking events in Northern America, and in fact it might even be one of the largest ones in the world. A lot of the events are on the Bureau of Land Management's Fort Ord National Monument. So every year, people come from all over the world to participate in all types of cycling events. And for months before the event, people will come out just to practice. And it's great because it's a wonderful time of year. So a lot of times we have the flowers blooming, the grass is green, and it's absolutely wonderful out here. So people really enjoy themselves. They come from all over the place, which means that they are coming to the local shops and restaurants and hotels, and everybody's having a wonderful time. So you provide the recreation and the scenery, and the people do come.
Most of the visitors, athletes and spectators and their families and friends, certainly come from California. Our largest demographic is up in the Bay Area. So we get a lot from San Francisco and Oakland and Sacramento and San Jose, of course. But it surprises me in how many we also get from Southern California. Quite a few come up from Los Angeles, Santa Barbara area, and even San Diego. Most people spend about 3 days at Sea Otter, is what our surveys show. So they'll come up not just for the event, but they'll stay and make it a vacation here in Monterey. Go to the aquarium, down to Big Sur, Carmel, and so forth. We'll have about 500 pro racers, and certainly with them come some of the world top racers, professional riders, and they'll use Sea Otter either as a direct competitive race. We sanction with the international sanctioning body, so during an Olympic year like this, they can come to Sea Otter and earn points to try to get on their country's Olympic cycling team. We have a number of manufacturers' teams, pro teams that come, both men and women teams that race Sea Otter. So we have a very large pro contingent, men and women, and then of course all the amateurs, thousands of amateur racers and riders.
We're here at Sea Otter for a couple of reasons. Number one, everyone that's part of our organization loves bicycles, so we're in bicycle heaven here. It's a wonderful event. I live in Capitola. We've been coming to Laguna Seca for years and years and years. So for us, this is just fun. One of the reasons that we're here is that we're in a booth. This is one of the vendors that we support. This company is called A2B. Kind of fits with our commuting philosophy. They're a German-designed e-bike owned by a company called Hero Echo. Their corporate offices are in the UK. And they're here, so we came to volunteer to assist them in meeting and greeting people who are in attendance at Sea Otter and giving them test rides on the e-bikes. We're also here because I have my accessories buyer here, and he's visiting all the booths looking for the latest and greatest accessories to offer to our customers. And that's why we're here.
Monterey is beautiful. I had never been to Monterey until I came to Sea Otter for the first time about 4 years ago. And I was amazed. It's incredible. It's beautiful. The people are friendly. The restaurants are wonderful. Just the environment out here is really terrific.
We're here at Sea Otter Classic with the Cal State Monterey Bay Kinesiology Department, and we're running a lot of different testing on fitness variables and some psychological variables, trying to create a descriptive study of mountain bikers and road race bikers.
Yeah. I love Monterey personally. It's my first time ever being here. I live in an area like this, but in Israel, which is a very tiny place. And seeing such a huge amount of people over here, that all active, all natural, all beautiful, always the right vibes, we love it. We will come here every year and we enjoy every moment that we are over here. We're surfing, We're getting the sun, we're getting cold, we're getting hot, we're helping people, we're traveling around.
The restaurants.
We love it here. We can take it. We're going to come here every year to the show and every other time.
What I've seen is a lot of growth the last few years, and our emphasis, business emphasis with the event that I have my people work on, really covers three areas. We want to get more kids to come out and embrace cycling. And whether it's a young child on just a balance bike, or you know, a young grade schooler that is having fun riding around on the bumps and berms and so forth that we set up at Sea Otter, it's important for us to get the children involved. And as part of that, we have an outreach program that the Sea Otter Classic Foundation hosts. And we'll go to local middle schools and a few months ahead of the event, or a good month ahead of the event. And you know, we'll talk about cycling safety and how to ride, how to wear a helmet, and get the kids you know, enthusiastic about cycling. The other emphasis that we have is to get more women involved in cycling. Right now, as far as athletes go, we'll have 25-30% of our athletes are women. And we'd like to get that number up to about 40%. And that would be much closer and representative of you know, our population and how many women can actually come out and ride a bike. So we have a number of programs and outreach that we do to get women involved in cycling, as do a lot of our sponsors. And the third thing that we really focus on is we have a pretty active veterans program where our vets and recovering vets are welcome to come out to Sea Otter and ride any event they would like for free, and to come out and use cycling as part of their recovery program.
You know, the future of the Sea Otter, I see, is a constantly evolving event where the sport continues to change. Road biking, mountain biking, electric bikes, tricks, downhills, they keep adding new events. And Sea Otter, which has been different than most biking events, they've evolved by taking in new events as they come along, because it keeps the interest of all those involved, and especially the younger riders, because they love something new. So I think I see that as the future of the Sea Otters, continuing to evolve with what everybody wants to do.
There would not be a Sea Otter Classic if it wasn't for Monterey County, and in particular Monterey County Parks Department, that have been huge supporters of ours right from the very beginning, you know, in 1991 when we first did the event. So without the Board of Supervisors approving our use permit out at Laguna Seca, and without the county and all the departments within the county working with us to have a successful event, there wouldn't be a Sea Otter Classic.
We're begging them to come back next year and to make it even bigger and even larger. So we're very excited about the turnout, the economic impact, and just how well this event went this year.